बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। और यू स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इज लेक्चर नंबर 20। सो आई विल रिवाइज द प्रीवियस टॉपिक्स in the previous lecture we explained ohm law gives relation between voltage and current, provide that the physical state or the physical condition of the body remains constant, temperature is constant, current will be directly proportional to the voltage. There is a direct proportionality between current and voltage and inversely proportional to the resistance, and V is equal to IR, where R is the resistance. Now from physical state, here we means physical state, we means temperature is kept constant, temperature is constant, and length and area remains same. Resistance is the opposition to the flow of current and is measured in ohm. Now we will explain this. Now ohmic and non-ohmic conductors, ohmic and non-ohmic conductors. So first, those material which obey ohm law is called ohmic material, in whose resistance remains constant with the passage of time. The resistance is independent of the voltage. This relation is called ohmic law. Material that do not obey ohm law are called non-ohmic, and those obey is called ohmic material. Now the graph between voltage and current is shown in the given figure. It is voltage and it is current. The resistance R is equal to V by I is independent of current for ohmic material, is indicated by the constant slope line. This represents ohmic material. Graph is a straight line, so it's ohmic material. This is a non-ohmic material, thermistor most probably. Filament of the bulb. Have this such type of graph. Now non-ohmic material. Non-ohmic material are those whose resistance changes with voltage or current. It depends on voltage and current. Depends on voltage and current. Here voltage is taken along x-axis, current is taken along y-axis. The current voltage relationship is non-linear. In case of non-ohmic material, a diode is a common example of non-ohmic material. Diode is semiconductor. Factors affecting resistance: nature of the material, length, thickness, temperature. These are the factors which affect resistance. If you compare copper with iron, both will have different resistance because their nature is different, their atomic structure is different, they have different number of free electron. So different metal have different properties, different number of electron, different number of construction, so will have different resistance. So resistance depend upon the nature of the material and the physical condition of the material. Physical condition of the material, and also depends on the temperature also. Different material have different resistance because some material are better conductor. Different wire has a higher resistance. Some wire have higher resistance and some wire have low resistance. nichrome, aluminium wire has a higher resistance than a copper wire of the same size, length. The longer a wire is, the higher its resistance. More will be the length, more will be the resistance. When electrons travel down a long wire, they can collide with more metal ions and then in a short wire. More will be the length, more will be the chances of collision. A thin wire has a higher resistance than a thick wire. More will be the area, less will be the resistance. So I will write it mathematically also. The higher the temperature, the more will be the resistance. Metal ions vibrate more at higher temperature, and so number of chances of collision increases. So we'll have high resistance. Factor affecting resistance. Resistance is directly proportional to the length. More will be the length, more will be the chances of collision. More will be the area, less will be the chances of resistance. So increase in area causes decrease in resistance. And resistance is directly proportional to the change in temperature. If you change the temperature, more will be the resistance. The resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to the length of the wire. Inversely proportional to the area of the cross section of the wire, dependent on the nature of the material of the conductor, directly proportional to the temperature of the material. So this is the equation that you should derive. This is called rho, the constant of proportionality, called specific resistance. Of the material. Its unit is ohm meter. Now next, conductor insulator. Why conductor are better? Metals are good conductor because they have free electron. The free electron carry energy from one place to another place. So any material which have, according to free electron theory, if a material have more free electron, it will be better conductor. It will conduct electricity and heat. Any material that allow electric current to pass through it is called conductor. Insulator, conductor. Copper wire is a conductor. And aluminium is conductor. Steel is conductor. Any metal are conductors. Plastic, rubber, glass, wood, cloth, these are insulator. Any material that does not allow electric current to pass through it is called insulator. Combination of resistance. Resistor is connected in two ways. Resistor can be connected in series combination and parallel combination. In series combination, resistor are connected end to end and electric current has a single path through the circuit. This means that the current passing through each resistance is same. In series combination, current each instrument will get same amount of current, and in parallel voltage is same, each instrument will get same amount of voltage. In parallel combination, one end of each resistor is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, while the other end of each resistor is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. Their voltage is same across each resistor. I will explain it more on the next page. So such a circuit in which there is only one way for the flow of current is called series. If any of the instruments stop working, all the other will stop working. And if there is more than one way for the flow of current, it means if one instrument stop working, the other will continue working. So this is called parallel combination. Now here is only one way for the flow of current. So if this resistance stop working, the other cannot, the current cannot flow through the other resistor. So it will stop working. In parallel combination, each instrument will get same amount of current, but different amount of voltage. I will now explain it more. Now, this is V1. This is V1, V2, V3, and you can derive this relation. Now, in parallel combination, current is same. Current is same. So, I amount of current. Resistor is R1, R2, R3. Each instrument will get different amount of voltage. So, V is equal to first resistance, IR1, second resistance, IR2, third resistance, IR3. Now, derivation of relation. V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. IR is equal to I into R1 plus I into R2 plus I into R3. Take I common. IR is equal to I R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is cancelled, so R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the equivalent resistance. Now, parallel combination. When there is more than one way for the flow of current, this is one way, this is the other, this is the third way. There is more than one way for the flow of current. Each instrument will get same amount of voltage. V, V, V. Current will be different because there is more than one way for the flow of current. So, in this case, V is equal to I into R1, I1 R1. V is equal to, through second resistance, I2 R2. And V is equal to I3 R3. Now you will do the quantity which is different. You can derive relation from the quantity which is different. So we will take I. Now total current is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So I into R equivalent is equal to V1 divided by R1 plus V2 divided by R2 plus V3 divided by R3. Write the value of R. This is I divided by R1. I divided by R1. Now, current is cancelled. We'll do again. I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So I is equal to V divided by R equivalent. V1 divided by R voltage is same. So V divided by R1 plus V divided by R2 plus V divided by R3. So V is equal to V divided by R equivalent is equal to V to 1 divided by R1 plus 1 divided by R2 plus 1 divided by R3. Cancel. So 1 divided by R is equal to 1 divided by R1 plus 1 divided by R2 plus 1 divided by R3. This is V equivalent. Now, when resistances are connected in parallel, the voltage, each resistance will get the same amount of voltage but different amount of current. And when they are connected in series, each will get same amount of current but different amount of voltage. Now students, I will make a little bit revision. Start this chapter in this week from current electricity. From current electricity, we define electricity in this chapter. Electricity. Anything which produces four effects: light, heat, sound, and motion. Then we explain branches: static electricity, current electricity. Then we define current. The flow of charges is called current. If it is due to the flow of positive charges, it will be conventional. If it is due to the flow of negative charges, it will be electronic. Current, the unit of current is 1 ampere. The unit of current is 1 ampere. 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb per unit 1 second. If 1 coulomb of charges flow in a time of, for a time of 1 second, the current is said to be 1 ampere. Then we explain conventional current, the flow of charges which is due to the flow of positive charges is called conventional current. How do we measure electric current? You can measure electric current by ammeter, digital multimeter. You can measure voltage with the help of voltmeter, and you can measure the resistance by ohm meter, and different physical quantity is measured with the help of different instrument. Now on page 92, a question is given. Quick quiz on page 92. So open page 92 and check. It is written how long does it take a current of 10 milliampere. Current is given 10 milliampere. Milli is prefix, so 10 cross 10 raised to power minus 3. 10 cross 10 raised to power minus 3. 10 cross 10 raised to power minus 3. And to deliver 30 coulomb of charge. To deliver charge is how much? 30 coulomb. So I is equal to Q by T. So T is equal to Q divided by I. Q is 30 coulomb and charge is 10 cross 10 raised to power minus 3. 10 cross 10 raised to power minus 3. So do it by yourself. Charge is 30 coulomb. Current is 10 milliampere. So T is equal to Q divided by I. Do it. Galvanometer. Galvanometer is used to measure current in very small amount. If you want to measure current, you will connect it the galvanometer with the resistor in series. And if you want to measure voltage with galvanometer, you will connect it in parallel with the device through which you want how much voltage is given to that device. If you want to measure voltage given to an instrument, galvanometer basically work on the Faraday law. We state that whenever a current carrying coil is placed in a magnetic field, it will experience magnetic force which will rotate the coil. Whenever a current carrying coil is placed between the poles of a magnet, it experiences magnetic force which will rotate the coil. Next, you will do it by yourself. Ammeter, current measuring device, instrument used to measure current, but it must be connected in series. Ammeter is current measuring device and galvanometer is voltage measuring device. Potential difference. Energy which is transformed or which is converted from electrical form to other form of energy. For example, tube light convert electrical energy into heat and light. electric heater, convert it into light and heat. So the energy utilized are converted into, are consumed from one form into another form is called potential difference. Potential difference is zero if current is zero. If there is no flow of current, potential difference will be zero. Potential difference is the cause. Is the cause. Now, potential difference is measured in volts. In potential difference, current will flow from higher potential to lower potential. This is the definition of electromotive force. I will write for you people. EMF, electromotive force. The force which produces the motion of electron is called electromotive force. Force which produces the motion of electron is called electromotive force. EMF is the strength of the battery. The strength of the battery. Strength of battery is called electromotive force. EMF is the cause. EMF is the cause. Potential difference is the effect. Measuring potential difference. If you want to measure potential difference across a device, for example, you want to measure potential difference across this device, well, the voltmeter must be connected in parallel. This is voltage source. Definition of Ohm law. Statement of Ohm law. Current and voltage are directly proportional, and V is equal to IR, where R is constant of proportionality, called resistance. Ohmic material, those material whose resistance remains constant, whose resistance cannot be changed, are called ohmic material. Which you, shortly you can define it, the materials which obey Ohm law is called ohmic material, and which do not obey Ohm law is called non-ohmic material. It obeys in a limits. Memorize the graph. Non-ohmic material, factors affecting resistance, nature of material, length, thickness, temperature. Factors on which resistance depend. Resistance depend on length, area, and specific resistance of a material. Conductor and insulator, which allow electric current to pass, is called conductor, which do not allow is called insulator. Which have those material which have free electron is called conductor, and which do not have free electron is called insulator. Combination of resistance. Now, remember students that when you are dealing with Ohm law, you must know three things. Ohmic material which have fixed resistance. Ohmic material whose resistance is fixed. Fixed resistance. Non-ohmic material which do not obey Ohm's law. Thermistor is the best example, and filament of the bulb which obey Ohm law in limits. Now, so Here, the graph are ohmic material, which have fixed resistance is straight line. Is a straight line. For example, this is current and this is voltage. This is the graph for ohmic material. Now, the next is filament of the bulb. Will move along this path and then it will bend because temperature increases. Temperature increases, resistance increases. Collision, chances of collision increases, and the flow of current decreases. Now, for thermistor, thermistor and bulb have same graph. Filament of the lamp. Is a type of thermistor. So you'll do it by yourself. Study it. Thank you, students. Wish you best of luck.